around the leaders of the villages and to the mamas and said, what do you need and what do you want? And these were the four things that they came up with. And they've been building on those for the last 10 years. I could talk about all four, but I came into this as a medicine person initially. And as I got to know each, I got really excited about everything else they were doing. And that's why I finally came into the company itself. But one we want to talk about today is their promise for food. When you talk about the promise of food, I look at it in three ways. There's a promise for immediate food, for food in reserve, and for sustainable food. When you talk about immediate food, you're hungry, you need something now. You have to have it. When you talk about reserve food, you have something put away in the pantry, or the kitchen, or in the refrigerator for the next meal, or maybe even for the winter. Talk about sustainability, you have to have a way to continue to get that food. And outreach has over these years learned that we can give immediate food, we can reserve, but we want to work on sustainability now. Outreach, as you may know, is a packaging company in part, and we package meals all over the country. They package, our sign now says 250 million, but I think we're over 300 million now. Meals that have been packaged throughout the country. And they've been used in domestic programs. We see them in food banks, we see them in pantries, and we're helping Americans who are in need and need food, immediate need, and also reserve need. But they also do international food too. Many of our meals are transported all over the world. They went to the Philippines, to Haiti, to Liberia, to Nepal, and of course, to Tanzania, where we have our children's care centers. In Tanzania, we have two children's food centers. And there we feed right under 1,000 kids a day with these meals. Those are immediate meals and also reserve meals. But once again, we want to talk about sustainability. There was a food crisis in 2007, 2008 when the world started to really realize we didn't do something, our population was going to die. So at the 2009 G8 summit, President Obama announced the United States' Feed the Future initiative. The Feed the Future initiative is administrated by the USAID. We always are saying USAID, and I don't know if everybody knows the words, but the United States Agency for International Development. And they are running this program and basically administering it. The brainchild of the USAID for looking at sustainability in food was something called WEED, the Women's Empowerment and Agricultural Index. And that's what I want to talk about a little bit. It's a needs assessment survey that was designed to help us figure out how can we empower people who are going to be feeding the world in the future. What can we have, how can we measure something and what does it measure? Well, this is the first time ever they figured out a way that you can put empowerment into a number. And this index measures production, women's ability to have say in their production, and it measures do they have access to resources. Do they have decision-making and resources? Do they have income? And do they have access to income? If they are making income for the family, do they have power over it? And leadership. Do they have leadership in the community, in the home, their time use? And it turns out to be that a side effect of this actually, a positive side effect of this index shows that they can look at gender inequality to see if women are being empowered or not empowered in the community. So this is the index that we talked about here. Why do we need this? Well, we figured out in order to feed the world, if we don't increase agricultural production by 75% in 35 years, we will have major famine. So the greatest sustainable return will be to invest in small older farms. And over 50% of the smallholder farmers in this world are women. Women, they are the ones that are doing the farming, they are the ones that are taking care of the family, and those are the people we need to invest in order to sustain and feed and make sure our nations are built and that our world, not just our country, but our world doesn't face severe scale problems in the future. Rewise is women engaging research to ensure a sustainable economy. So what is WeRise? Well, WeRise is the index and the study that Outreach, along with the Rotary Club of Des Moines and Rotary International, has look at the needs of women farmers, smallholders in Tanzania. The study is designed specifically for Tanzania and for a Maasai village. There is nowhere in the world that they have ever actually done any survey similar to this, the women or men in the Maasai village. It has also never been used in Tanzania before. So this is a unique index that's going to be very, very helpful. I want to let you know the people who have helped with this, Dr. Betsy Richey, who is the data manager program for the Iowa Department of Public Health, Deborah who has his master's in rural development from Moines University in Tanzania, and Tracy Sawyer, who's a founder and CEO of Testigo Africa, which is an NGO that is helping teach Maasai women to grow crops and capture rainwater, because they don't usually do that, and so they don't have water to use. So they have been helping with this survey. In order to do this survey, we went through many pages of questions and that, and we took them from the WEA index, and we took them from the WHO index, and from the another health survey, International Health Survey, and put a survey together that has about 150 to 200 questions. So it's taken a while to put it together, but now we have the original survey ready to go. The interesting thing is that we have it in English. So our next step is to translate it into Swahili and into Mama, which is actually the language that inside Mama. And we actually found someone who is fluent in all three languages, amazingly enough. And so we're going to be using them to do our translating. Then our next phase will be, of course, to do the survey after the pilot has been done. Well, why are we doing this? Why is outreach interesting? Well, you've already heard that we're very interested in helping others. We're interested in hunger. We're very much interested in Tanzania. We are invested in Tanzania from our hearts and our souls and our hard work. So we wanted to see if we can create greater economic and educational opportunities for Tanzanian women. We also want to help make strategic planning more valuable, since the information that we get will be taken directly from targeted populations. So we won't be taking the data that we got in Uganda for this study and trying to put it in Tanzania. We will take specific information from our own villages to use to help develop our programs. And what will happen then? Well, we will empower the world's leaders in anthropology, small holders, farmers, and who are they? A lot of them also. So, outreach programs have a long history of working with people in Tanzania to understand their needs before developing their programs. As I said in the beginning, before Kathy and Floyd first decided what they were going to do, they went to the villagers and they went to the mamas and said, what do you need? And that's how they decided. This index will take us to them and say, what do you need? So, we would like to help these people and these women and these our friends in Tanzania to have a better life and to save the world from hunger. Just remember, you can't help until we know what is needed. You can't help yourself until you know what is there. So thank you.
Thank you all for coming. We have a booth right at the head of the escalator. All three of these people and five with Gordon and Kathy will be there to answer your questions and talk more. Please join us at our booth.